Guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm actually going to be teaching you how to cut a flounce. As you can see, a flounce on my dress. Most of my subscribers, they've been asking me to teach them how to cut a flounce. There are different ways of cutting flounce. There are some other complicated ways, but today I'm going to be teaching you a very simple way to cut a flounce, and you'll still get the same result with this method. So I want to say a very big thank you to all of my subscribers. If you have not subscribed to my channel yet, please do subscribe, like this video, share this video, comment on this video, and also you can ask me any question you want. You can tell me if you have any problem with sewing, you can tell me, I'll answer you. If you have anything you want me to make a video on, you can also tell me, I'll be so glad to do it. And when it comes to attaching of flounce, it totally depends on you. You have to work with manipulation. What I mean by manipulation is, you have to, as you're placing it on your fabric, you're just gonna be manipulating it. You turn it to wherever you want. As you're fixing it, you'll be turning it to your desired result. That is how to actually attach a flounce. So now let's get to my table and let me cut it for you to see. Thank you so much. So now, I'll begin by folding my fabric into two. Like I told you initially, this is a short, it is a short flounce, not a very long one. You can join it though. So I'll begin by folding my leftover fabric. I'll fold it into two, then fold it into four. I'll get my tape. I'm gonna be making use of the entire length of my fabric. And what I have here is 12 inches. So I'll mark here the 12 inches. So I'll put it note where my tape is. 12 inches here. So 12 inches. 12 inches. That's the entire length of my fabric. So I'll mark it out like this, and then I'll cut it out. So now you continue by folding another one. At the end of the day, you place it like this neatly on it. Make sure it is equal, so you don't run into any problems. So the next thing, it depends on how, now what I'm going to be doing now depends on how wide I want my flounce to be. So you can always estimate it with your, like I said, you can always check that out with your, depends on the fabric, that's the dress that you are making, how wide you actually want it to be. So like me, for this, I want my flounce to be, the width of my flounce, I want it to be 5 inches. That is what I want. I want it to be 5 inches, but because I'm going to be sewing and turning it, so I'll make it, I'll leave it at 6 inches. I'm measuring it from the down part, if you notice. I'll leave it at 6 inches because I'll use half inch from to turn it from the down part, then half, another half inches to attach it. So I'll measure 6 inches from the down part. As you can see, I'm negotiating my curve from the down part. I'll join my lines together. I'll make sure it's equal, so I'm gonna be double checking. This part is a little bit long, so always make sure you check properly. Then I'll take my scissors. Like I said, always cut outside your lines. When you are done, you can always trim it to your desired result. At the end, you take your scissors and open it from the side. You can see my flounce already. You can see it. So now, what I'm gonna be doing now is I'll open the second one. To my machine and turn, then iron it. I'll bring it back and show it to you. So you take the down part of one piece of your flounce. This is how to join, so before you turn, as in to turn it, and take the other piece, you place it together like this, and then you sew all the way through. You are cutting, make sure the both parts are equal. If not, you run into problems, but if it's equal, everything will go smoothly. As you can see, this is it now. I finished sewing it, I turned it. So now, how you're gonna be placing your flounce on your dress depends on you. So this is the dress where I'm gonna be placing it. You can manipulate it any way you want. You can decide to put it, turn it. If you want a flounce that stands, you can iron your gum stay and your strong hair stay on it, and it will stand like the one I showed you initially. I wanted that one, but this one, since this one is a thinner dress, I wanted the one that will just flow with the dress. I don't want the one that will be standing. So you can manipulate it however you want it to your desired result. So you can always attach with your machine, or you can use a needle to attach it. You can and just work your way through it. As you're doing it, you'll be looking at it. So I've come to the end of this illustration. If you were able to try out your flounce, tell me, let me know. Like this video, comment on this video, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so, and click the bell by the side of the subscribe button so that anytime I post a new video, you can see it. And if you want, if you have any request, you can always tell me. I'll grant your request. If it's something that I can do, I'll do it. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye, and God bless you.